Yeah.
My microphone seems like it's static.
You're static.
Yeah. I don't know. Microphone's tight. I don't know. I don't know who runs these shows before I get here. I can only assume it's Paul Amir. I can only assume it's Rob Repos.
I don't know.
They screwed up for us so that our show is sabotaged. Yeah! In the 12, Infinity War here with
a little Kay Kendra.
And this is the show where we tell you some of the events going on through the week here in Niagara.
Yep.
I don't know why you killed the music. Is it just too staticky? I feel like I need a, yeah, I need a little, give me a little of that little Kay.
Yeah.
And,
getting a little bit of jazz before we go punk.
You know what I like, though?
What?
You know how many years I've been complaining about doing Hit the 12 in the wintertime?
Yeah.
How many years we've sat outside and had to freeze to do promos and stuff before we got a studio? How many years I wanted a studio?
Yeah.
And finally, it's here.
Yeah, I know.
Because you would have had me outside.
I would have. Yeah.
Freezing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Multiple takes.
Multiple takes, freezing.
I would on the funny thing is that the majority of the time when we made mistakes, it was because it was like the only times we had to do multiple takes was in the middle of winter when it was so cold.
Yeah, it was just too damn cold.
We had issues.
Yeah, it was just too damn cold.
Yeah, but other than that, we could do it in like one take.
Yeah, well, when it's cold like that and you got me standing in front of an ice sculpture in Iron Lake, or you got me in Fort Erie at the, where, the, you know, remember
when they had the, yes, whole, like, it all, like, built up, all the ice?
I just posted it. Yeah. It came up as a memory. And I apologize.
Was it that one or the one at the ice rink? Remember we did at the skating rink, Gretzky's?
And oh, I fell? Yeah, it might have been the skating rink. I didn't rewatch it. I, a lot of times, don't rewatch it because I'm embarrassed to watch myself.
Me too.
Yeah, so I just
Remember them in my head.
And honestly, I don't even think anybody cares. I just do it because that's what the thing is to do these days, you know.
Share the memories.
You gotta post something, you know.
Yeah. So we got a great show coming up.
Yeah.
Great show coming up.
Right.
We're going punk. Of course, we're going to do our local events.
Sure.
But we are going punk.
Punk music for the hour. A special guest from a punk band.
Yes.
Putty.
Paolo
from Putty.
Paolo.
And
which
possibly
always reminds me of Friends. And possibly, I'm pretty sure she's coming.
Yeah.
The Viz.
That would be great.
Yeah.
From the Viz show here on 4680. You can hear it Saturday mornings.
She interviewed Paolo this past Saturday.
Yeah, this past Saturday. And the show is on the Friday. And it's in a couple days at Camp Cataract.
Yeah.
On the 19th, Putty is back, a band that was formed in 1993, and they got a lot of history. In fact, at one time, I think they... This is a great question for you. I didn't hear this quite clearly, but I think they were going to be signed by Sony, and at the last day got punked out.
Oh, I don't know. I thought I read that they were.
Oh, maybe they were.
With Sony. Which would be a really cool question, because... No. My dad would have been there in 93.
Right. Yeah.
So
there you go.
Yeah.
So there's some
that's an interesting,
some history that might not even be history. It might even be just fake stuff. I don't know. I wasn't really paying that much attention, but I was listening
obviously
to the Viz show. I was listening to the Viz show. You can get that on Spotify. That's where I got it, the Viz show with the Putty on there. And I kind of heard it as I was getting in out of the car. I don't know. Is everything working here? It seems like I touched something and the wires are all... I guess it's good. Sorry.
I think you're fine. Anyways.
All right.
I want to talk about some current events.
Yeah.
Before we get to some local events and our interviews and such like that.
Mm-hmm.
The Princess of Wales. You know, I'm a big royal follower. She is in hospital right now because she had abdomen surgery.
Mm.
What does that mean? We do not know, because all they're saying is that she underwent abdominal surgery.
How old is she?
She's 43? 42. Sorry, 42.
Could be the C word.
There could be a whole bunch of things.
Could be prego.
Abdominal, could be intestinal, could be the uteri, could be anything, right?
Maybe she's got
They're not
Crohn's
saying
disease.
Anything. She's in there for 2 weeks.
Okay.
So.
Well, that's great.
That's
news.
Interesting. Yeah. Yeah. The king was also in the hospital. He has to have prostate treatment.
I wasn't in the hospital. I don't need prostate treatment.
The king of England.
Right.
Was in the hospital. He's having prostate treatment.
So the king and her in the hospital. Him for prostate and her for abdominal.
Yeah.
So it must have been a sexual
thing. No, it's not. It just proves that, yeah, they're royalty, but, you know, they get issues. Time, yeah. They get issues just like, they have health issues just like we do.
Well,
however, on the flip side, you know they're getting the royal treatment. Right?
Nice joke,
at these hospitals.
That's good comedy there.
They're getting like private rooms, private nurses, you know, the food that's fresh and
what
stuff like
not?
That.
What if they're not? What if they're just in the community?
Oh no, you know they are. You know they are. You know.
Right.
So there's a lot of snow. Well, at least in Fort Erie and such.
Yeah.
There's a little bit of snow here in Niagara Falls. There's even less in Niagara-on-the-Lake.
Well, as a resident of a former resident of Fort Erie, that's what used to happen all the time. It would start in Buffalo, and you would always see like the people in Buffalo like shoveling. Yeah, it's just wire, I think.
It's got to be. Stop messing with stuff.
You would always see them hiring the community to shovel out the seats in the Bill Stadium. Whatever it's called.
Well, they did that this weekend.
They did that this weekend.
And they still had to postpone the game.
And it was
Monday.
A job that I always wanted to do, be honest with you, because I think I could just smoke weed and yeah, free food.
Pretend to shovel,
yeah.
And get fed.
Yeah.
And get paid $20
yeah.
an hour.
Yeah, look for Channel 2 News and get on camera or something. And
that's exactly what
say
Sean
hi
said.
To mom, yeah.
Yeah, pretty much. But did you know, like, so there's all this snow. Like, there isn't enough snow in Niagara-on-Lake to put to toboggan.
Anyway, hold on
but
a minute.
But in Toronto,
yeah.
They banned, like, 47 hills for tobogganing.
Yeah.
Oh.
Go ahead.
Erin's here. Oh, she's got a key?
Yeah.
Beautiful. Okay, so they banned 47 hills for tobogganing. How much does that suck?
Do you have extra pair of headphones in your car?
No, there's one right there.
They don't work.
Oh.
She can
I do have an extra.
Well, hold
on. I can do this.
On you? Okay.
Yeah, remember?
Yeah.
Remember? Okay. Well, while I do that, I'm talking about this whole Toronto has a ban.
Yeah, I wasn't really listening.
You never really.
I just saw the Viz walk in.
I know.
There she is.
You
the
never.
The Viz is here in the studio. We're live on air.
You never listen when I talk.
Watch what you say.
What's up?
I heard a lot of swearing in your podcast.
I'm getting you some.
Hello, lovely people.
Hello. I'm getting you some headphones, but the cord isn't long, so I don't know how that'll work.
I don't need headphones.
She doesn't need headphones, but when we're getting
you can
a call
still
in
hear us, I can
from
hear.
Paulo. So, oh, yeah, I thought you would be included in on that.
Here, I can sit, like, on the desk.
Sit over there. Just move the mic. Yeah. Oh, yeah. There you go.
Oh, I need my little, my adapter thingy. Hold on.
Actually, you could use these headphones and give me those headphones.
Yeah, but I got to get an adapter here.
Sure?
Yeah.
Let me grab an adapter.
I should have brought my headphones.
That's all right. I was thinking about messaging about that, but
my adapter. Is there an adapter on that pair of headphones?
No.
You said they don't work.
No, they don't work. We're and sure. There's no adapter.
I can't.
Okay. There's no we're adapter gonna, on that?
No, I have it in my car, but.
Or I'll play some music and go to your car.
No way. Not
we're going to figure this out.
All right.
We're going to figure it out.
What a horrible show it is so far.
Am I on?
Yeah, you're on.
Yeah.
Hello.
There you go. Beautifully done.
Yeah.
The Viz from The Viz Show, Saturday mornings at what, 11?
At 11.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I just had Paulo in the studio, and
well, that's what I noticed, and that's why I messaged you, because I was like, I didn't want her to think that we were stepping on
stealing
toes.
Stealing my people.
Stealing the people.
Yeah.
These are my people.
But I'm actually glad it all happened. I'm glad it all happened, because I love that you're here, and we're doing this with you.
Me too.
And I was like, you know, the Viz is going to know a lot more about punk music than I am.
Or I.
Yeah. So
not,
I was like, maybe
really
she's
either.
Good to have inside here on the show so that she can dive deeper.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I do deep dives.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's exciting.
I appreciate that. Thank you for having me.
It's going to be fun. It's going to be fun.
I'm the morning girl, so this is like a different vibe for me.
It's a different vibe. It's nighttime out.
Wednesday nights are a different vibe.
It reminds me of that show I used to listen to. It was like AM radio. It was like all about aliens and stuff.
Art Bar. Art something. Art.
I want to say Cosmo.
Art Vandelay.
No.
No, art. People would call in.
Yeah, it was a nighttime talk show with these crazy phone callers.
Call in and
what the hell was his name? He had a nationwide radio show. It was big.
Is your eye okay? Yeah. It just like
I got something stuck. In it.
I've had something in my eye for the past like 2 hours. And I just came from a class. And I was like, there's something in
that. Oh, well, I'm sorry about that.
It's a tear. I'm just so happy to be here.
We're happy that you're here, of course.
Yeah. So we are, we're going to do a couple events in a second. So you get to see us do our fun event stuff.
Yes.
Where we share all our local events that are happening.
I love this.
Around Niagara. It's not just
That's
music.
What you do.
Art
it's
Bell.
Not what you do. You guys are the event.
By the way, Art Bell was the name of the radio guy. Sorry. Cares anymore.
Yeah.
Who was it?
Art Bell.
But he did, what was the show called? Coast to Coast.
Coast to Coast with Art Bell.
Okay.
Perfectly done.
And it was
I don't think
eerie
I ever.
And cool. And it's not, I don't think it's a thing anymore.
No, it's not a thing. I think he died, actually.
I never really listened to AM radio.
Oh, it was good.
To be honest.
Yeah, nobody listens to it anymore, but it was good back in the day.
Unless it was like 610 or something for the like traffic reports.
Just when you were on
growing up.
Yeah.
I listen to 610 every morning.
Really?
Oh, really?
Tim Dennis.
Yeah.
Shout out to Tim Dennis.
He's great.
Yeah.
He's been there a long time, man. Probably the longest.
Yeah. Have you met him?
No. No, I don't think I did. When I did CKTB, it was Tom McConnell in the afternoons. It was Rod Mahood doing Game On.
He's still there.
I think he is still there. Yeah, he is still there.
Rod is? He does the
sports show on Saturday.
And he does the Ice Dogs.
And he does the Ice Dogs on Kojiko. Yeah.
Yeah, well, at the Ice Dogs games, not on Kojiko. Well, the Ice Dogs games are on Kojiko.
Well, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah. They have a game tomorrow night, actually.
Right.
If I didn't have my bestie Thursdays, I would be working it, but.
Oh, so you're going to give up working for your bestie Thursday.
Yeah.
Okay.
What is Bestie Thursday?
Oh, here we go. Someone wants to get in on Bestie Thursday.
Bestie Thursday. Yes. Me and my best friend get together and we cook food and we paint and we have some drinks and some...
Yes, but you're on dry January. I was just reading. So
yeah.
Have you made it all the way through?
I post these things and I'm like...
Why did I do that? Because now I want to drink.
Why do I do this to myself? Like, what, I'm so fucking saint or something?
Right.
I know.
But
yes.
I feel like I need to share my journey, even if it's a fail or...
Yeah, true.
A complete... I just try to be as real as possible.
I've been a creepy
of
your journey for many years.
You have to fail to achieve.
Thank you. Oh, and you're still survived.
I survived, yes. I always thought your stuff was interesting. And when I broke into doing this with Kendra, that I was like, who is this girl? She's here, there, everywhere on Queen Street. It's like you own Queen Street. Oh my God, I can't believe I'm not
There's
thinking
a crew.
That. Yeah, there's a crew. There's the Taps crew. Levi Mann, yeah.
Yeah.
He's another one.
Matt
Gressy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes. Who's your bestie from Taps? I don't know why I'm slipping on the name.
Ashley Standish.
Yes.
Yeah, Standish.
No, I wasn't talking about
Ann
Ashley
Martin.
Standish. I was
Ann Martin.
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
But Ashley Standish, yes. And then I guess that's it, right? And the crew from Camp Cataract.
Ashley Standish is another bestie of mine.
Yeah.
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 My Son the Hurricane. And original, her own stuff.
Now she's been on the road a lot of time.
Yeah.
Like, I
haven't
seen her
in years.
Well,
because she does a lot of stuff
with my... everywhere.
Yeah.
Like, it's insane watching her just flourish with, like, she has the dream.
Yeah.
Like,
the whole band. My Son the Hurricane.
Dano runs the band. And he's the one who gets them in all these festivals. Like, they played with the Foo Fighters.
Yeah.
They played, like that was in the Ottawa's... Blues Fest.
Right.
Ottawa Blues Fest.
Yeah.
And now they're like going to France and stuff. Like next year, they're you know, they're just expanding. They're just like, go, 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 go.
Mm-hmm.
It's awesome to see. Like,
I don't know how many members they have to fly
up to, up to like 15, I think they said. 15, 14, 15. Oh, okay.
We got a all phone right. call.
Hold on. Should I just go to music?
Yeah, go to music.
Okay, let's go to some music first.
All right.
Welcome back. That was What Do You Want from Putty.
There we go.
And we are now joined
by Paolo himself.
No, yes. Paolo, sorry for this horrible introduction.
What is so horrible about it?
You know.
I said his name.
I know, but there's also another member here tonight.
Okay. JV, yeah, JV. Hey, I'm here.
All right, JV.
See?
Hey guys,
I wanted to do a better
introduction. Go ahead and do the introduction,
but Jay
then.
Cut me off.
Yeah, well, we could start over.
Yeah, let's start over. That's what I'm trying
Mulligan,
to say.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Welcome back. That was What Do You Want by Putty, the band, playing this Friday at Camp Cataract in Niagara Falls on Queen Street. We are joined right now by Paolo and JB.
Horrible.
Thank you very much for that wonderful introduction.
Horrible introduction.
Well, that was better than what you
all right.
did. You messed it up.
So big show happening just a couple days on the 19th here at Camp Cataract. The band is back together. You got to be feeling good.
Yeah, feels great.
Yeah, we're pumped.
We've been sort of long time coming. We've been playing and recording and doing all this stuff for a few years now. This sort of reunion got going before the pandemic hit, so obviously there were delays and all sorts of stuff, but it's this will be our first show back, so wild card. yeah, who knows what'll happen.
That's awesome. And so for Paolo, you're in town. For JV, how was the traveling?
Oh, the traveling sucked. I left Timmins at 7:30 this morning and got in here Niagara at 7:30 tonight, but it was just the usual stuff, you know, winter road cancellations, but that's what you do for music.
I find it really funny that you guys are spread around the country.
We're from Timmins, actually. The band started in Timmins and long time ago.
Yeah. Okay, so that's where it began. And it's funny because they label you as a Toronto-based band, so for some reason.
Well, yeah, that was sort of where we developed a following. So in the late 90s, like 99 to 2005, around that time, we were doing okay, and we had relocated to Toronto. So that was sort of how we were known at the time. But even then, like, people were living in different cities and stuff. So it's never been ideal.
Yeah, this is nothing new for us. Yeah.
So how is that when you are recording?
It's a bit of a pain in the ass. It's but we have a system. It's like guys will come in sort of on their own schedule whenever somebody can come in, and we'll arrange a session and then pick up all the tracks that they need to pick up. Everything is demoed beforehand, and then we replace all the demo tracks as people come in to record. Usually Eric is taken care of first in Montreal, so we'll do a big session and capture all the drums, and then we do everything else here in St. David's.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And then it goes out to mix. Vic Florencia mixed this record.
And with this, how different was it recording this new music compared to, years ago? Is there a lot of change in how you've planned it out and how you've gotten together to put the music together?
In the past, we would have all of our songs sort of ready to go because we were banging them out in a rehearsal space. So we would just usually just rent a week in a studio in Toronto and then, track it and mix it all in one place. But, this is quite different because this has been sort of a longer process.
Way longer, yeah.
Yeah, more time to mull over stuff and pick it apart and become unhappy with it and redo it.
Well, I am not, I've listened to the music, and I really like it, but I'm not really I've never been a punk connoisseur, as some would put it, but I'm just wondering, in the business of music, is there a difference in genres, like, compared to pushing a punk band and, you know, pushing a rock or a country? Or
we were always positioned as a rock band. I don't know where the punk title kind of came from, but that seems to be what people are saying now.
It's because we do so much ourselves.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's pretty DIY, but we're a hard rock band sort of at the end of it. I don't know. We had a major major label record deal in the early 2000s. That didn't turn out so well. We didn't get very much attention from the label. Like, they would rather work on urban acts or, you know, whatever else was coming through the door. We seemed to be, you know, prioritized over what we were doing. Okay. And then eventually we got dropped completely.
But, oh, wow.
Yeah, that sort of led to the decline, which led to our hiatus. But yeah, I don't know. We don't really give a shit about the business, really. we don't care.
Well, that can be a good thing, right? Because when you're focused too much on that, it kind of takes away the fun of actually creating music and playing.
It definitely does, yeah.
Yeah. We're dinosaurs too, yeah. So we woke up, it was like we went to sleep and woke up on a different planet.
I feel like a dinosaur too.
It's crazy how different things are now. So we just, I don't know, we're just going to do what we do and who cares, whatever.
All right.
People like it, great.
That's pretty punk rock.
There we go, yeah. Okay. So then that's where it comes from.
I suppose.
Yeah. It's the attitude, yeah.
I'm wondering, you know, with your, you know, the harder rock and such, what weird non-rock genre would you pull a lot of your influence from?
I listen to a lot of synth wave, a lot of electronic music. Eric and I actually have a synth band. Oh. It's instrumental.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Music videos and everything. Anyway, yeah, I'm not here to push that one.
No, but we're here to push Camp Cataract this Friday.
Yes, yes. Synth music, a lot of soundtracks. Listen to a lot of soundtracks. I don't really listen to rock music a lot.
Well, any top 40? Horrible, embarrassing music that you love?
We won't admit to it.
You know you're not going to do it.
Depends on the year. I don't know, anything past... anything past like 2009, I'm probably shrugging my shoulders.
Okay. Well, what about something from the 80s? Something embarrassing from the 80s that you just love? From the 80s that you just love?
Something embarrassing?
Kenny Loggins, Top Gun. Yeah.
Oh, that's not bad.
Yes. I'm super into Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. What else?
No Cyndi Lauper.
No. Yeah, I love Cyndi
Lauper. Duet, yeah.
For the Bangles.
Yeah. I love the
True
Bangles.
Colors.
I know, right?
True Colors, yeah. Don't tell anybody, though. Oh, Kenny Rogers. Yes.
Okay.
You know what? I'm going to look at my records here. I'm sure I can fish something out that's horribly embarrassing.
Was that song, you know, some Video Killed the Radio Star?
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Wham.
Yeah, Wham.
Wham, yeah. Well, actually, we were going to do a Hall & Oates cover. We were thinking about doing You're Out of Touch.
Okay.
So that may make an appearance. not a Camp Cataract.
No. You have another show on Saturday. But
yes.
Friday, Camp Cataract, have you seen the venue yet?
I have.
And what are you thinking for the show on Friday?
I think it's going to be very loud.
Okay.
I think it's going to be very loud and
loud and high energy. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. The venue is great. I've seen a few shows there now. They have wonderful hot dogs, which I went on and on about in Aaron's show.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hot dogs. Is it like street meat?
Is he keeping them on the menu?
Oh, he's keeping them.
Okay.
Oh, good. You know what?
Is it like...
I
don't know if it had anything to do with my
on Friday.
My tangent, but yeah, they're going to be there. I've been reassured.
I'm interested because I grew up on Toronto street meat.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, they're more...
Is it
artisanal? They're more artisanal.
Okay, so it's not like, you know, you can get like shredded cheese and bacon.
Oh,
and
you can. Yeah, like totally. It's not, you know, those dogs and those things have all disappeared.
I know.
Like gone.
Yeah.
Off the face of the planet. Yeah, the meat was a little suspect sometimes. You would bite into like something that had the consistency of a nose or
a tire or something. Yeah.
I don't know. My guy at high school in Agent Court in Scarborough, he was just outside like the fence to our high school. Freaking $5 a day, freaking hot dog or sausage and a can of pop. And he had, like, fresh shredded cheese, bacon crumble, like, sauerkraut,
that sounds like high-end. Yeah, I would go to the guy on Spadina and Queen, and it wasn't nearly as robust.
It was awesome. It was the best.
It was sauerkraut at ours, though.
Okay,
he had sauerkraut at that one.
He had, like, onions and peppers. And
I'm hungry.
Yeah, all different sauces and stuff, too.
I don't know how much airtime I've blown on the station about hot dogs.
Yes, but there's going to be hot dogs this Friday at Camp Cataract.
There are. So if the band suck, you can get fantastic hot dogs.
Oh, you guys are not going to suck. Can you tell me a little bit about your openers?
Ivy Gardens. Heavy.
Ivy Gardens.
Yeah. Sort of a stoner rock kind of thing.
Perfect.
Pretty groovy. They did a cover of Walk Like an Egyptian, I believe.
Huh?
Oh,
Bangles. There's
yes.
one.
Yes.
Love it.
Right?
Love it.
Nice.
Yeah, they're fantastic. Super high energy. I was watching some of their videos online. I haven't seen them live yet, but wow. Yeah, love them.
That'll be exciting. Again, that is this Friday.
Yep.
The 19th, Camp Cataract, which is right on Queen Street in Niagara Falls. downtown Niagara Falls. We're super excited to have Putty. I want to link your website to get all the information, but I still have another question for you. It's Putty TV.
Yep.
On the interweb, you got a Facebook page and Instagram and such?
Yep, putty.tv, and yeah, we're on all over the socials.
All right. And I have I just had a question. Oh, okay, yes, merch. I saw some new merch you have.
Killer merch. Oh.
That you have going on. Can you talk to us a bit about that, and will it be available on Friday, and otherwise, how can we get it?
The MASH, as in the TV show MASH.
Yes.
It's it's our logo in black on a military green T-shirt. They look fabulous.
That's beautiful, yeah.
Yeah, we got our own silk screening set up now. When we dove into this thing and relaunched the website, we started off with this drop shipping thing, and it's pretty predatory business model.
Yeah.
Awful, actually. So, we went to the trouble. We made the investment, and now we're doing our own merch, our own shirts. There was also some logistics problems. People were ordering vinyl and a T-shirt, and they would get tapped for double shipping because the shirts obviously had to come from somewhere else. So that was shitty. So we fixed that by getting a machine, and now we're making some cool shirts. There's some baseball tees, too.
And you can just grow from there because you have all your own stuff now, right?
Yeah, whatever we want. We've got a great one. I gave you my love. You gave me the clap T-shirt as well. The title of our last single.
Oh, my gosh. I don't know if I'm going to play that one. But my
Know, that was the song that won us Rock Search in 2000, and they refused to say that's the name of the song on the air. They did for a while, and then they just turned it into I Gave You My Love. I would call into the station every time, irate, but it didn't make a difference.
Yeah, of course not, because they have all those rules and stuff we don't hear, which is why we love being on 468 Q, because we don't have those rules.
No rules.
We can we can promote what we want, when we want, how we want.
That's right.
Fantastic.
This Friday, Camp Cataract.
2 days.
Yes. It's 2 days away.
It's 2 days.
Yeah.
You need to get there, get your hot dog, enjoy some hardcore music. Check out Putty. Thank you so much to you guys for being here. I hope you enjoyed your time with us. And
we did. Thank you very much again.
And thank you so much. We're going to play some more of your music.
Awesome.
Because that's just what we do. We love to promote and support what's happening in Niagara. And again, you guys are playing this Friday.
Awesome.
Camp Cataract, Niagara Falls, Queen Street. Thank you so much. Wish everybody a goodbye, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks. Take care.
Bye.
Thank you so much. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Let's go to some more Putty. Oh, I gave you my love. You gave me the clap.
Woo.
Speaking of. By the time of the there we go.
I'm waiting for you.
now, you sold me out to move it up. You traded up, you traded up, you're cashing out. I'm blowing time, I wasted mine, I'm taking those.
Just to let you know.
Yeah. We're on live right
now. You're out there talking.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'll talk for a bit.
All right.
I can't.
Yeah. We're gonna go through a couple.
Well, I brought the Viz in for Apollo.
Hello.
Yeah.
And because she had Apollo, and I was like, wow, this would be great to have the Viz in too.
Yeah.
That was a genius idea.
And you talked about a hot dog, and now you want to leave.
I know.
I want to go make a hot dog.
I know.
Now I'm going to camp on Friday.
Camp on Friday.
Gourmet hot dog.
There you go. Yeah. It's going to be a good show.
It's pretty sweet.
I heard the boys are not going to play if the hot dogs are not going to be sold. That's what I heard.
Rumor is. A little dramatic. I don't think so. There's just going to be a lot of hot dogs sold.
I heard it on the Viz show. If you listen to the Viz show, you would know that. But
Saturdays.
There you go. Saturdays at 11 a.m. The Viz show.
Tune in.
On all the platforms. There you go.
Yeah.
And Putty down at Camp Cataract.
Yeah. And James Underwood coming on this Saturday, I think.
What, at Camp Cataract?
No, on her show.
Oh, on your show. Yeah. Who's that, James Underwood?
Rink and Poop.
Okay.
He's got an album that he's released.
Okay, beautiful.
That's all I know.
Yeah, beautiful.
Beautiful.
James Underwood, look forward to that. Saturday's 11.
We have people on next week, don't we?
Jen Downey's coming in next week from Clockwork.
Oh, yes. And the lady from the Niagara Salsa.
Yes.
Social.
There you go.
Cool.
Yes. Yeah. And I got nothing planned for Saturday, so well, probably be nothing.
Sucks to be you.
Wing all right. It.
Yeah.
We're just going to have to wing it.
Yeah.
Let's
do some events.
All right.
Let's get through them.
All right.
Because we've got less than 20 minutes.
Doesn't matter. No one's telling us what to do.
Know,
no one's
true.
Telling
we
us when to leave.
Longer.
We can do whatever. We have to go longer. We have to go longer.
Okay.
You want me to go first? Because I lost my notes.
Okay, well, I'll start then. Belly dance classes. They happen Tuesdays and or Fridays, going from January 9th to February 9th.
Yeah.
So a whole month. So Tuesdays and or Fridays for belly dance classes. Learn how to shimmy and move your hips. This is a great way to exercise, meet people, and learn about yourself. You can get 10 sessions for $150.
Not bad. Not bad. Let me tell you about Catch the Ace. It happens January 6th all the way to June 1st, little K, and it's happening at the Fort Erie Legion. You heard about it in other towns, but now's your chance to try it here. The Fort Erie Legion, Branch 71, and Fort Erie Lions Club present Catch the Ace, which I already said.
Yeah.
How does it work? Each ticket gives you a guess. Find the numbered envelope and the ace in it, numbered 1 to 52. You find it, you win the cash prize. The longer it takes to catch the ace, the higher the prize amount. It's just that easy. You can buy your tickets at the Fort Erie Legion for $5 each, three for $10, or seven for $20. Tickets are on sale.
I was so confused.
What? You don't understand this?
I didn't understand it. I think it would have to be like shown to me.
Well, you could just rewind it in the podcast.
Yeah, or you can look at Hitting the 12 events page and actually read it.
Or you can let me finish. You can buy your tickets at the Fort Erie Legion, $5, $3 for $10, $7 for $20. Tickets are on sale in the foyer at the club room bar all week long. Sales stop Saturday at 6:45 prior to that week's draw. Draws are every Saturday at 7 o'clock. And it's licensed, little K.
Oh, my favorite.
Come for the draw, stay for the live music.
Woo-hoo!
There you go.
Friday, 5 p.m., Club Roma, Porchetta Night.
Woo!
Yeah. I don't really know what porchetta is. I'm thinking it's something pork-related. But Friday at 5 p.m.
Should have done some research on this.
Good now. You can enjoy a homemade porchetta sandwich accompanied by their delicious house salad, roasted potatoes, tea, and coffee. They're going to be serving up a succulent and perfectly seasoned porchetta that will have your taste buds dancing with joy. Share with your foodie friends who would love to enjoy some porchetta with you. Club Roma, Gemini Room, January 19th, 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. Walk in, dine in, or take out. I think that's pretty sweet.
And check this out. Come out to Heartland Forest and explore the wonderful world of winter birds. Bring the whole family and be inspired to take home your bird feeder while you take a short self-guided hike through the protected forest and see how many birds you can find.
Oh, I love that.
Take a trip through the treehouse and explore the lifelike models of our local birds. I read this exact same thing last year. Please purchase tickets per child.
Year.
Adults accompanying children are free to attend. Once the ticket is purchased, feel free to drop by, drop in anytime between 9:30 and 11 o'clock. Tickets are $2.50 per child.
Nice.
All yeah.
Right. I got another one. You can.
Yeah, it's cheaper than anything. Yeah.
Cat and Monkey, Friday night at 7 p.m. 4548 Queen Street, Niagara Falls, right down here. You can make your own spiritual oils. You're going to join Mistress Cat while she teaches you how to make your own spiritual anointing oils. Our ancestors used oils in ceremony and ritual hundreds and even thousands of years ago. These oils can be used for both anointing people and objects, such as candles and such. In this class, you will learn about and make your own magical blend for use in your personal practice. It's $30. Prepayment is required to register, and payment can be made via e-transfer to catmonkeyevents@gmail.com.
This one here, there's a lot to go over, but I'm going to try to get through it as quick as I can. It's Trius Ice Wine Maker Dinner. Wow, I'm in a rough shape
Trius
tonight.
Trius Ice Wine Maker Dinner.
Friday at 6 o'clock. Join us Friday, January 19th for our annual ice wine-themed dinner in our underground Trius Red Barrel Cellar, hosted by a member of the Trius winemaking team. You will be greeted with a glass of Brut on arrival and prepare your palate. That's what I'm trying to say.
There you go.
For a delicious meal, you'll be seated for a communal table and served a three-course meal prepared by Chef Frank Dodd and this culinary brigade, along with the wine pairing selected by our winemakers. Trius is a pioneer in the ice wine world. We all know that. Being one of the fine
Niagara Estates to make it. The grapes are harvested at minus 10 degrees Celsius and pressed frozen to release one drop of pure liquid gold. The results are concentrated flavors of and a rich sweet taste profile, which comes in a pairing with white food and recommended with small glass alongside aged blue cheeses. Rich savory items such as foie gras and pâté.
Foie gras and pâté.
Spicy food, citrus fruits, sushi, dark chocolate, and fruit-based desserts.
That's quite the mixture.
Yeah. Reserve your spot online by calling Wine Country Concierge. How do you say that? 1-888-510-5537. Please let us know about our $120 per ticket, $115 for the That's Ice Wine Club members, and up to 5 guests, plus tax and gratuity.
All right.
So there you go.
Okay. Saturday, 11 a.m., our friends at Yoga Dome are having a somatic sound bath and meditation event. Blue Raven and Ashley Michelle are going to host a deeply introspective journey. Somatic Sounds integrates body work with sound therapy with rhythmic sound resonance. You'll be guided through a body scan meditation that will shift you into a deep state of connection. This will transition the physical body into a deep rest and relaxation. As we shift into our somatic sound bath, sound waves and vibrations will shift the nervous system into a deeper place of consciousness and connect and send healing vibrations into the body to target areas of pain, stress, tension, and trauma. No experience is necessary. Dress warm and comfy, but I know the Yoga Dome is warm and comfy as it is.
Mm-hmm.
So come as you are. All meditation props, mats, and blankets are available for you to use. Tea is also included. Sign up at theyogadome.ca.
Discover science shows. Discover Science Show. Introduce your little scientist to the main parts of science, chemistry, physics, and biology. Exciting experiments drawn from across the spectrum of science show kids that although there are all kinds of science, all science is about asking questions about the world around us. After the show, explore the museum, galleries, and complete a scavenger hunt. Pre-registration required. Children under the age of 12 must be accompanied by an adult. All attendees, including adults, must have a ticket. We reserve the right to cancel the show if not enough participants enroll. In this instance, all enrollment fees will be refunded. Register at 11 a.m. for the show. Register at 1 p.m. for the show, January 19th. $5 for or free for members.
All right. Was that it?
Yep.
All right. I got a paint and sip with Steve Wilson. Great, great artist. Saturday, 7 p.m. again at Cat and Monkey. You're going to start the new year off right and join local and internationally renowned artist Steve Wilson in creating your own unique work of art. Steve Wilson is an award-winning artist and juror. He is an elected member in the Federation of Canadian Artists, the Ontario Society of Artists, Society of Canadian Artists, and so much more. He has exhibited nationally and internationally across Canada, the United States, England, Tasmania, and Turkey. He's going to guide you in creating a one-of-a-kind personal piece of art. One glass of wine or spirit is included in ticket price. Per person. So it's $45, 19 plus event, obviously, because there's drinking. Pre-registration is required. Again, payments made via e-transfer, catandmonkeyevents@gmail.com.
On Saturday, January 20th, 2024, stop by the Seaway Mall for an enchanting wedding show. This one-day event is a must-attend for all soon-to-be-wed couples seeking inspiration and guidance for their big day. Discover a ton of local vendors specializing in every aspect of your dream wedding. From the latest trends in menswear to exquisite jewelry, talented photographers, stunning decor rentals, and so much more. We have it all under one roof. Whether you envision a traditional ceremony of modern celebration or our vendors will help you bring your vision to life, don't miss this exclusive opportunity to meet the best in the wedding industry and turn your dreams into reality. Mark your calendars for Saturday and join us at the Seaway Mall for our wedding show that will leave you inspired and ready to embark on your journey happily ever after. Want to become a vendor? You can apply for that as well at seawaymall.com/events/wedding show. And pricing for outside vendors are $150 plus HST. Pricing for Seaway Mall tenants is free. Woo-wee. So there you go, little K.
Whew, all right, let's get to some more local music. We're going to go to Ivy Gardens, who is playing with Putty this Friday at Camp Cataract. So I figure we'll do a couple of her songs and then come back and do the live music listing for Friday and Saturday.
All right, let's do it.
Let's
play some music.
Do that. Ivy Gardens up all night.
Thank you.
wonder.
Sorry, we're on the air. We're on the air.
Oh my god!
Warning, we're on the air.
That was awesome. So that was two songs by Ivy Gardens, who are opening for Putty.
Yes.
On Friday.
Now, Viz, you were digging that.
I was digging it. I can't wait to see this band live too.
Yeah.
Yes.
I know.
His voice was phenomenal, and it sounded so. I don't know.
Yeah.
It's good. It's good.
Yeah.
That's going to be great. Great show happening Friday.
Yeah.
Ivy Gardens.
Yeah. But we've got Putty. More live music.
Yes. We're nearing the end of the show, and this is where we tell you some of the bands that are happening in the bars and clubs Friday and Saturday. I'll start with the 19th. That's Friday. With Putty playing at Camp Cataract. No need to mention that because we've mentioned it all the whole show. But the rest of the bands, Back to the 80s, will be at the Reeb House Whiskey Chasers at Putty's. Play on words there.
Yeah.
Best Behavior at Golden Brothers. Stuck in the 90s will be at the Spice Lounge. Maple Jam at Grand Central. Neon Rain at Big Texas. Under the Sun at Chip and Charlie's. Jammer will be back at Parker's Pub. Feverish Lemons at Cat's Caboose. Neon Dirty at the Dive Pub. And X Prime will be at Rombie's.
No.
That was perfect timing.
No, was it?
That was perfect timing.
Da-na-na-na.
All right.
It's my spot.
Da-na-na-na. All right, all right,
all right. Clockwork at 40 or 8 Legion, JDM at Golden Brothers. Stuck in the 90s at the Angel Inn and Maple Jam Duo at Ollie's. Hard Rock Hooligans at Chip and Charlie's. Jammers at Pitchers. Slider is at Cat's Caboose. Neon Dirty at Lefty's. Vinyl Flux at Rombie's. Stereo Stars at Trailsides. And Rock Vegas is at Putty's.
There you go.
Did you
Putty word.
Yes, putty.
I know.
It's
like
me neither.
Years.
No, I haven't either. I think that's what I used to call Play-Doh when I was in kindergarten. Get the putty out. Yeah.
Get the putty out.
It's everywhere.
I remember there used to be the Nutty Putty. You would come in a little nut kind of thing, and then you would get putty.
The name is named after.
I do.
No.
Yes. I listen to the show.
It was the putty that they used to come. They
have
these ear.
It was ear. Oh, to clean the ears.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think people still do.
Well, he said one
that.
Of the members of the band were going to buy a pair of headphones, right?
I'm
going to
try.
People do that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So there you go.
Yeah.
So that's what's happening this week here in Niagara. There's your music. Putty is at Camp Cataract with Ivy Gardens. The Viz Show, catch her Saturday at 11 o'clock here on 4680Q. And what's your guest again? Tentatively?
Not sure. We're not sure yet.
We're not sure, so.
James Underwood.
It's probably going to be James Underwood.
To hear from
in his underoos.
James Underwood, get at me.
Yeah.
In his underoos.
James Underwood, get at the Viz, man. It's to get
James,
some.
It's James Putty, actually.
Stop with the putty, damn it.
Enough. All right.
And the Viz will also be at Camp Cataract on Friday, so you can get a meet and greet with the Viz, selfies,
buy her a hot dog.
Buy her a hot dog, damn it.
Buy her a hot dog.
Buy me a hot dog.
And, of course, all the events that we mentioned tonight are on our Facebook events group
page.
That's
right, yeah.
And, of course, there's more events on there that everybody else shares.
Yes.
And we invite you to share your events
so
that we can engage the whole region.
I have an event.
Yes, go ahead.
That you guys haven't mentioned.
The Warehouse?
Yes.
Talk about the Warehouse.
Okay. So, the Warehouse, there is a show happening in honor of Sam. He was a bass player. I don't know his full name. I apologize. But it's a metal show at the Warehouse.
Okay.
Okay, so we got Under the Red is there.
Yeah.
And, what's that other band? I see you guys have the list in front of you. Oh, let's go. Wait, let me check.
The list in front of us. We didn't mention
we don't.
The
there's no list in front of us. What are you talking about? There's nothing in front of us. We do this all by the top
the
of our heads.
Because, I want to. Dustwalker.
Okay.
Dustwalker.
Temple of Night.
Temple of Night.
You
and,
sound heavy.
Under the Red.
Under the Red?
Yep.
Yeah.
You sound heavy.
Yeah.
It's going to be heavy. It's Metal Night at the Warehouse.
June 19th. At the Warehouse.
That's also this Friday.
Fade to Black, a memorial show for Samuel Raven.
Okay.
So excellent. We got his full name in.
Hold this out.
Share that event. Share that event on Hitting the 12 Events page.
I will.
Right.
Because we got a whole bunch of that stuff going on. Check out our media page for where we post all the links of our past podcasts and such.
Yes.
And don't miss listening every Wednesday night live here on 468.
Yes. I want to get out of here. My toes are frozen. It's freezing in here. And the Viz and for Little K, I'm Infamous Jay Moore.
I'm Little K Kendra.
And we are hitting the 12.
Thank you guys for having me.
Of course, Viz.
I love seeing them.